Justin Davis sprints into the front court. He's denied. Jackson's there to slam it home. You gotta be kidding me. Amaro, a contested three off the rim. No. Rebound, Pennell. Here come the Nighthawks. McDaniel looks to jam it home, and he does. What a dunk by Josh McDaniel. The home team into the snap into the front court. Alley-oop putting it up. It's actually a three-pointer. The Kavion White banks it in for three. My God. Live from Oaklawn Foundation Gymnasium in the Kettle on the campus of National Park College in Hot Springs, this is National Park College Nighthawk men's basketball on your home for the Nighthawks, the Nighthawk Network. Good evening and thank you for tuning in to this edition of Nighthawk Basketball. I'm Mark Oliver, sports information for Nighthawk Nation. Tonight's game is brought to you by the following sponsors, by Natural Hearing Centers and by Ouachita Children's Youth and Family Services Prevention Programs. Allen Tillery Auto Group, a proud sponsor of Nighthawk Athletics this season, as well as CHI St. Vincent. First Security, proudly supporting Nighthawk Nation in 2023. First Security, bank better, and Hot Spring Sports Medicine and Physical Therapy. Thank you so much for your support of Nighthawk Athletics. If you would like to support the Nighthawks this season, you can do so by visiting np.edu/athletics. Well, NJCAA Region 2 play is in full swing for the Nighthawk men, and coming off of a big win against UA Cossetta on the road on Saturday, the Nighthawks look to stay in the driver's seat as they keep momentum here on a Monday, playing host to the Mustangs of Central Baptist College. It'll be the third meeting of the season between the Nighthawks and the Mustangs, just kind of looking to keep the legs fresh, keep everybody from getting cold as they prepare for some big conference matchups coming up this week. It'll be Thursday on the road at North Arc. Saturday, they'll be home. We're a big one with SAU Tech. And, of course, games with Shorter and ASU Mid-South on the horizon for this team as well. The Nighthawks are sitting pretty right now in NJCAA Region 2 play. They currently sit in the tied for the first seed overall. And if you think about it, they're really one half-court buzzer beater away from being in sole possession of number one. The Nighthawks 4-2 in Region 2 play. Coming into tonight's game, the Nighthawks averaging 88.6 points per game. They shoot about 50% from the floor. It's impressive. 36 from beyond the arc and 71 from the free throw line. And they rebound about 37 per contest, ranked in the top 10 in the nation in field goal percentage, and they are led by a plethora of strong athletes top to bottom. The Kavion White leads the team in scoring with 16 points per game, 13 points per game for Patrick Punch, 12 for Quintez Grimes, 12 for Jabriant Hill, and 10 for Justin Davis. We see you guys out there on the live stream. Let us know where you're watching from and who you're here to see. Doesn't matter if you're a Mustang fan or a Nighthawk fan. We would love to give you a shout out tonight. Thanks for spending your Monday with us. When we come back, it'll be the opening tip between the Mustangs and the Nighthawk men. Back in a moment here on the Nighthawk Network.
If you or a loved one is suffering from hearing loss and looking for life-changing technologies and compassionate care, the Natural Hearing Centers is the place. They truly take the time to build a genuine relationship with you, which makes all the difference in the world.
I love the fact that John's hearing aids have helped him reconnect with family and friends, and it's improved every aspect of his life and mine.
Give Natural Hearing Centers a call today. It will change your life.
Baseball is how I rise above alcohol and drugs.
Arkansans appreciate community. We work and raise families, care for our neighbors, and come together in good times and bad. At First Security, that local strength is what we love best about our home state. There is commitment here, and heart, and hope. Thank you to everyone who is standing together, learning from one another, and making Arkansas a place we all love to call home. We're proud to be your community bank.
Success comes with many challenges. At National Park College, we've created programs that provide the tools to meet those challenges. Experience a university atmosphere at half the cost. Visit National Park College and find your path.
Back here in the Kettle, it is game night here on your Monday evening. Thank you so much for joining us for Nighthawk basketball tonight. As we look at the starting lineups, first for the CBC Mustangs, Hakeem Hancock, number 4. Number 5, Tay Calloway. Number 10, Devin Hughes. Number 11, Trey Tippin. And number 20, CJ Scott will start things off for the Mustangs in today's game. And while we have a moment, we'll take a look at your starting lineups. For your National Park Nighthawks tonight, it'll be Quintez Grimes, Justin Davis, Jabrian Hill, Nakavion White, and Tyshawn Pinnell. A little special something for you here today. Want to give a special thank you to Phil Godwin for his help on this one. I believe it's the first time here in the Kettle. We've got the spotlight out. As we announce the starting lineups tonight, shout-outs to Aaron Brewer. Sorry in advance for the darkness. These Nighthawks fought hard on Saturday on the road at UA Cossetot to get a big Region 2 win, and we looked at the Region 2 standings just a few moments ago, and this one is really fun to watch unfold with a big win. With South Arc beating ASU Mid-South, it really threw this entire NJCAA Region 2 into chaos and honestly puts the Nighthawks in a really good position to do good things this year. Now, how the playoffs will work in the beginning of March is the top two seeds will have a first-round bye, and then the number 3 and 4 seeds will have home games against the number 5 and number 6 seed. NPC currently tied for that first-place overall seed, and if they win out, thanks a little bit to South Arc, this could be the first-ever Region 2 win for NPC in program history. They're looking for sole possession of first place, and they're looking to keep pace in that race tonight as they take on the Mustangs of Central Baptist College. So once again, it'll be Grimes, Davis, Hill, White, and Pinnell getting the starting nod for NPC tonight. Special thank you to Josh McDaniel helping us out on camera this evening here in the Kettle. Quintez Grimes stands at center court with Hakeem Hancock, and we're ready for tonight's tip-off. The tip is controlled by NPC, and a little football move there from Jabrian Hill to Tyshawn Pinnell. We are underway here in the first half. Nighthawks want to start strong. They want to start big. As they feed it to Tyshawn Pinnell, floats it up and banks it in for 2. The Nighthawks are on the board. Tyshawn Pinnell with a bucket. And let's see how the Mustangs respond here. A 3 from the corner won't go. It's picked up by Devin Hughes. And the Mustangs will get another shot up top. Hughes feeds it up to CJ Scott up top. Rounding the way to Trey Tippin. Seven on the shot clock. The ball is knocked away. Quintez Grimes comes up with the loose rock. Feeds it over to Jabrian Hill. And the Nighthawks going with that two-guard system to start tonight's game. Says Coach Dylan Hargrove, he says, this is the best way we match up against the Mustangs. We want to do big things early, and we feel like this is the right combo to get it done tonight. Tyshawn Pennell drives in traffic. It's good. 4 points for Pennell to start tonight's show. 18:55 to play here in the opening act here in the Kettle. We apologize. We had a brief issue with our camera. We are back on track. We got the Justin Davis Fan Club watching out there. Hello, Olivia. Your big sister and nephew love you so much. Thanks for tuning in tonight. A lot of Justin Davis fans on the broadcast. We see Melissa out there as well. Shout-outs to all the Nighthawks. Glad to have you. Justin Davis is going to draw a foul as he goes to the hoop there, and he'll have free throws coming. So the mojo in the live stream. Good news for number two as he heads to the line shooting two. 18:28 to play here in the opening act. First free throw is good. Davis misses the second one. Rebound picked back up by CBC. Back in action here in the Kettle. 18:23 to play. Here's Trey Tippin across the timeline looking for a little bit of help. Nowhere to go. Tippin front and center. Feeds it on the inside. CJ Scott, the first Mustang basket of the game. 5-2, Nighthawk Nation. Nikavion White to JD. Justin Davis from the free throw line brings it home for two. 3 points for Justin Davis. Let's see how the Mustangs respond here. Errant pass picked up. Long three on its way, and that's Hakeem Hancock with the tray. That puts it at a two-score game, or a two-point game, I should say. Jabrian Hill with the rock for NPC. Feeds it to Grimes on the wing. He'll try for a three of his own off the front of the rim. No, gets his own rebound. Grimes loses the ball down low. It's picked up by Tippin. Here come the Mustangs into the front court. Scott dished out down low. Reverse layup won't go. And the Kavion White comes up with a big rebound. Back and forth we go here in the Kettle. Put up the alley-oop. Grimes can't field it. Comes up with the ball. Needs a little bit of help. He's triple-teamed. Jabrian Hill to try to extend the lead. In and out, no good. 17:07 to play. Tippin takes his time crossing the timeline. 3 minutes off the clock here in the first half. 7-5 NPC. On the inside, CJ Scott. They'll move it around. Long three by Tippin. Can't get it. Another big rebound for Jabrian Hill getting the start tonight for Nighthawk Nation. Justin Davis, smooth moves. Hangs onto the rock down low. It is stripped away, taken away by Tippin. Here come the Mustangs. Tay Calloway came up with it. Back to Tippin across the timeline. Tippin front and center. Fit in on the inside, Scott. Long three on its way. Calloway gives the Mustangs the lead. Two threes for CBC here in the first. It's 8-7. First lead of the ball game for our friends from Conway. 16:16 to play. Jabrian Hill drives, turns on those jets. We talk about him all season long. JB Hill's on the board with two of his own. 9-8, back and forth we go. About 4 minutes off the clock here in the first half. Hancock with the rock. Back to Tippin. Calloway pulls away for two, but it won't go. Air ball picked up by Nikavion White. Fed to Tyshawn Pennell. Pennell to Jabrian Hill. Hill drives baseline, feeds it out to JD Justin Davis. And the Nighthawks will try to set it up with Nikavion White. Feeding down low to Quintez Grimes to Pennell for three. Won't go. Rebound picked up by Devin Hughes of CBC. Here come the Mustangs. 15:25 remaining. Justin Davis in the zone defensively. Nearly stolen away by Nikavion White. Hancock shot won't go. Scott can't get it. And I believe we're going to count the bucket for C.J. Scott and the Mustangs. J.B. Hill out to Nikavion White. White, the bounce pass down low to Grimes is intercepted. So it will not be a goaltending after all. The bucket will not count for Callaway. The score remains 9-8. Picked up by White. Cross-court pass to Jabrian Hill. Hill all alone lays it in for two. 4 points for Jabrian Hill, tied for the team lead for NPC. Three-point ball game. Callaway across the timeline. Tippin across the timeline. Fed to Tay Callaway. In the corner is Hancock. He pulls up for a long three. Can't get it. And a big rebound for Jabrian Hill. Another board for number three. And Hill turns on the Jets. Fed out on the wing is Justin Davis. Davis drives baseline. It is knocked away out of bounds. Nighthawk basketball. Want to say hello to the Tyshawn Pinnell Fan Club watching from NYC. Hello, Joanna. Hope you guys are doing well. Thanks for tuning in tonight. 14-12 remaining. It's Grimes who has the ball stripped away by Hancock, picked back up by CBC's C.J. Scott. Hancock spins in traffic up over a man, can't get it, and it's taken away by Justin Davis. Over to Quintez Grimes, one-on-one, up over a man, and it's up and in for two. Quintez Grimes does layups too, ladies and gentlemen. We're still waiting for that first big dunk of the night. But Grimes is on the board with two. The lead is five, 13:41 to go. Pinnell with the defense front and center against Trey Tippin. On the inside, that one stolen away by Nikavion White. White, front court, bounce pass, Pinnell. Pinnell looking to finish strong, and he does. 6 points for Tyshawn Pinnell. Timeout on the floor, Central Baptist College. A seven-point lead for Nighthawk Nation. Back in a moment here on the Nighthawk Network.
If you or a loved one is suffering from hearing loss and looking for life-changing technologies and compassionate care, the Natural Hearing Centers is the place. They truly take the time to build a genuine relationship with you, which makes all the difference in the world.
I love the fact that John's hearing aids have helped him reconnect with family and friends, and it's improved every aspect of his life and mine.
Give Natural Hearing Centers a call today. It will change your life.
Back here in the Kettle, I'm Mark Oliver with National Park College. 13:27 remaining in the first half. Nighthawks up 15-8. CBC basketball coming out of the Mustang timeout. Here's Trey Tippin as he makes his way across the court. Tippin guarded by Nikavion White. Definitely a size mismatch there. The bounce pass on the inside. A shot is up and off the mark by Gabe Jackson, who checks in during the timeout for CBC, trying to add a little bit more size to the floor. NPC boasting two really big men in White and Grimes. Fed out to Justin Davis, top of the arc. Out on the wing is Jabrian Hill. Pass intended for Nikavion White, tipped away, and it's going to be controlled by Hakeem Hancock for CBC. Hancock from around the free throw line, up and in for two. Hakeem Hancock with 5 points for the Mustangs in this one. And there's Quintez Grimes to the hoop for two. Apologize for some of the camera issues. We're working to get those addressed here. Looks like we're backing up and running. 12:28 to play. Tippin driving inside. Swarm needs a little bit of help. Feeds it back outside up top. It's Tay Callaway. Callaway to Hancock. Wide open for three. And that is a big one for the CBC Mustangs. 8 points for Hancock. 12:10 to play. Jabrian Hill drives. Dished out to White. White thought about a three. Feeds it into Pinnell on the run down low. It's good. Tyshawn Pinnell, right place, right time. 8 points for the Nighthawks for the young man from Long Island, New York. Great start for number 13. 11:50 to go. Tippin, swarm, double team. Pinnell up high with the pressure for NPC defensively. Callaway fires one up over a man. It's good. And there's Jabrian Hill with the answer for the Nighthawks. 21:15, 11:30 to play. Tippin has it taken away. There's a reach-in foul. It's going to be against Nakavion White of NPC, his first and the team's first tonight. Nikas Jackson's into the ball game for NPC. And Jackson had a great showing Saturday on the road in Locksburg against UA Cossetot. Had a lot of foul trouble for this Nighthawk team. But when the going gets tough, this team gets tougher. The depth on that bench is incredible. 11-13 to play. Callaway double team. Feeds it up to CJ Scott up high. White and Pinnell applying the pressure. Four on the shot clock. They'll feed it in, and a shot in traffic is good. It's Drew Baxter with his first bucket of the ball game for two. And CBC keeping pace. Two-score ball game with 10:55 to play. Jabrian Hill sizing up the defense with Trey Tippin. Hill trying to set his teammates in motion. Turns on the Jets, trying to part the seas, but it's stolen away. Tippin comes up with a loose rock. Mustangs into the front court. Grimes with pursuit. Down low, shot is blocked by Nakavion White. Dished out to Grimes. Grimes feeds it to Jackson, who lays that one in for two. Great passing, great teamwork for the NPC Nighthawks. Jackson's on the board with his first field goal in the ballgame. The lead is six. 10:20 to play. Bounce pass on the inside has C.J. Scott. He's swarmed, taken away by Tyshawn Pinnell, controlled by Jackson. Here comes NPC. Jackson drives and misses the dunk. Picked up by Jabrian Hill. Right place, right time. NPC will get a reset here. Pinnell, the deep three off the rim, no. Grimes secures the loose ball with the rebound. Another shot for NPC. This time it's Hill driving in traffic. Grimes can't finish. Jackson with the loose ball, and Hill missed. Now a foul. One way or another, NPC was determined to finish with points. Nikas Jackson's going to try it from the free throw line with two free throws coming. 9:48 to play. Halfway through the first half of action here. First shot for Jackson is good. The lead is seven. Two for two. 4 points for Nikas Jackson coming in off the bench. 9:45 to play. Jackson with the cross court finds Tay Callaway. Callaway from beyond the arc pulls back for three. It's good. Another big three for Tay Callaway. That's the fourth tray for the Mustangs here in the first half. The Nighthawks have yet to find one beyond the arc, but we know they're coming. 9:21 to play. Jabrian Hill, and there's going to be a push foul by Trey Tippin. Just a physical defender. Tippin will be charged with his first personal. That's the third for CBC. Nighthawks will inbound on that far sideline. Tyshawn Pinnell to bring it in. Pinnell, the inbound is tipped. It's stolen away by CBC. Looking to take it all the way home. It's up and it's in. A.J. Lomack for two. From the three-pointer line, Nakavion White will be fouled. And he'll head to the line. With three opportunities here. White looking for his first points of the ball game. And we'll adjust our scoreboard here to match what's in the kettle as White knocks down the first one. I believe it should be 26-22, but we'll work to get that addressed as soon as we can. White's second free throw is good. White with one more free throw to go. Got it. So Nakavion White's on the board with three free throws. The Nighthawks are 6 of 7 from the line. 11 minutes into this ball game. Here's a long three by Jackson. Too hard, won't go. Rebound picked up by Nikas Jackson for NPC. Justin Davids floats it up for Nikavion White, who goes down hard. A little penguin slide there. He's okay. Nighthawks still looking for that big first dunk tonight. Gabrielle's on the live stream. Hello to you, the Tyshawn Pinnell fan club in full force tonight. Glad to have you with us. First free throw, good for Nikavion White. Hakeem Hancock back into the game for CBC as Drew Baxter takes a seat. One more shot coming for Nikavion White. Looking to boost the Nighthawks to 30 points here in the first half, and he does. Nine-point lead, according to the scoreboard here, 30-21. Jackson has his hands full of Nikavion White, but a reach-in foul is going to stop him in his tracks. Foul is going to be on Nikavion White. I believe that's number two on White. Second NPC foul here in the first half, been a relatively clean one so far. Hakeem Hancock to bring it in. He finds Jackson, Gabe Jackson for CBC. Fed in down low. Lomax shot in traffic. Won't go. Justin Davis comes up with a loose ball. Into the front court. Nikavion White. White dished out to Hill for three. Off the rim. No. The tip up. No. Nikas Jackson will try to get another opportunity here. The ball is tied up with a jump ball. And it's going to go to CBC. 8:19 to play here in the first half. Gabe Jackson. We'll feed it to A.J. Lomack, and here come the Mustangs. Great crowd on hand tonight here in the Kettle. Cheering on this men's team, looking to win its third straight. 8:04 to play. Hakeem Hancock to the hole. It's good for two. 10 points for Hancock. The first Mustang in double figures tonight. First player for any team in double figures tonight. Nikas Jackson has that one knocked away. Last touch by Jackson. It goes back to the CBC Mustangs. Gabe Jackson brings the ball up the floor for Central Baptist. Lomack in traffic. Davis applying the pressure there. They feed it to CJ Scott. Scott up over a man, misses the rim. It's out of bounds. So NPC gets it right back. White to Hill. Jabrian Hill takes his time and looks to set up the offense here for NPC. Bounce pass has Quintez Grimes in the middle. Over to the Nikavion White. Loads it up. Knocks it down for two. First field goal of the ball game for Nikavion White. He has seven. 7:08 to play. Lomack, front court, guarded by Nikavion White. White in his face. And there's a steal by Quintez Grimes. Grimes pulls back, looking for the alley-oop to White. Can't quite get it to go. White is fouled, and he'll head right back to the free throw line where he is 5 of 5 tonight. The foul is on Hakeem Hancock. That is his first, team's sixth. First shot, no good. White not happy with the miss. He'll try to make good on the next one here. An opportunity to build a double-digit lead for the first time tonight. White with a rare double miss. The rebound by Jackson, but he loses it. Picked up by CJ Scott. So here come the Mustangs. Gabe Jackson across the way. I believe we're going to fix the shot clock here. It didn't get started after the rebound. We'll set it to, it looks like, 26 seconds. Nighthawk Nation out in full force tonight. Men and women's soccer is in the building. I see baseball. I see softball. Women's basketball here, despite not playing tonight. And I love this NPC family, the way they turn out for their teams. Doesn't matter who's playing. Everybody's going to watch. Knox is here in the student section. Some NPC staff and faculty as well. Hanging out with us here on Monday evening is a big block by Nikas Jackson. Rising up the ranks in the top 10. And CBC will inbound from the baseline. They'll feed it out to Hakeem Hancock. Long three on its way. Off the rim, no rebound. Nikavion White. White makes his way across the timeline. Driving, looking to go coast to coast. He dishes it out. There's the jam. Nikas Jackson knocks it down for the first slam of the night. We knew they were coming. 6 points for Nikas Jackson. He had 18, I believe, against UA Cossetot. We've got a travel call here called against CBC. NPC is going to get it right back. So it's a double-digit lead for the first time tonight. Just less than 6 minutes remaining, 5:56 to play. Nighthawks cruising here in the first half. Jabrian Hill slowly makes his way across the bird. Here we go. Hill driving, has a man in his face, needs to get it away, finds Justin Davis front and center. Davis, not afraid to get his hands dirty, trying to draw a foul call there, didn't get it, it's out of bounds. But a hard-fought ball game so far in this one. CBC has it. Trey Tippin calls out the shots as he crosses the line. Hancock front and center off the screen by Grimes. Pulls back for three. Nothing but net. Another big bucket for Hakeem Hancock. That's his third tray of the game. He has 13. 5:13 to play here in the first half. Jabrian Hill to Nikavion White. Down in the wing. White thought about three. Davis takes the three. But can't make the three. Rebound picked up by C.J. Scott. Trey Tippin pursued heavily by Quintez Grimes. Out to Hancock. Hancock driving in. There is a charge foul as Justin Davis takes one for the team. Nikas Jackson fan club out there. Hello to you. Thanks for tuning in tonight. Nikas Jackson with 6 points for the Nighthawks tonight. Colby West is into the game for NPC as Quintez Grimes takes a rest. And a team that spreads the ball so well. Tyshawn Pinnell leading the way with 8 points. 7 for Nikavion White, 6 for Nikas Jackson, and 5 for Justin Davis. Here's Davis top of the key. Guarded by Callaway, out to Colby West on the wing. Nikavion White slams it home. 9 points for Nikavion White. This Nighthawk team feeling the energy here in the first half. 4:17 to go. The ball is tipped away, and a diving play made by Tyshawn Pinnell. Coach Hargrove was trying to get a timeout called for NPC to try to bail Tyshawn Pinnell out. Put his body on the line there. And that's one thing you love about these Nighthawks. Doesn't matter what the score looks like. They're going to give it their all every single play. Big things in store for this team this season. Here's Tate Callaway. Callaway up over Nikas Jackson. Knocks it down. Not an easy task by any means. Callaway having a great game. He has 10. Nighthawk basketball. 3:55 to play. White driving. Gets past C.J. Scott, can't finish at the rim, rebound West. West in traffic, knocked away, there's a foul. So Colby West will be headed to the free throw line looking for his first points of tonight's game. West representing Bradley, Arkansas. First free throw, no good. Second shot, no good for West. He misses them both. We've got a foul on the rebound. I believe it's against Nikas Jackson. It's his first. 3 fouls for NPC, 8 for CBC here in the first half. On the wing, Jackson's going to pick up a second one very quickly here. And let's see if Coach Hargrove readies a substitution for Nikas Jackson. May keep him in, 3:35 to play. Substitution checking in for the Mustangs, number 23, Dwayne Lockhart. Trey Tippin with the bounce pass on the inside. Fed it to Jackson down low. Now a floater for two in traffic. No, tipped away by White. Stays with CBC. They'll get another shot here. Up and off the rim. Can't go for Drew Baxter. Nighthawks come up with the loose ball. It's Nikas Jackson across the timeline. Jackson looking for a little bit of help. Feeds it back out to Tyshawn Pinnell and the Kavion White up high. White from the free throw line to Justin Davis. Couldn't get the step back three. Drives in baseline looking for the foul call. He got it. Davis headed to the line, shooting two. Justin Davis is one of two from the free throw line tonight. 3:05 to play. The first shot for Justin Davis. No good. Rebound picked up by Colby West, but it's taken away by CBC. Lockhart moves his way up the floor of the basketball. And we're going to have a official timeout to fix the shot clock. 2:56 remaining here in the Kettle here in the first half. Probably closer than the Nighthawks really want this game to be. Tay Calloway and Hakeem Hancock are in large part to blame for that. They've had a great night so far here in the first half, respectively. Here's a long three. Lockhart can't get it to go. Rebound, Colby West. West is fouled on the rebound, and we'll have free throws coming. We'll bring this down the floor. Colby West is headed back to the line. West missed two, his first time up. And this should put NPC in the double bonus. Two free throws coming for Colby West. First one's good. And Colby West avenges the two misses with two makes. The lead is 10. West on the board for the first time today. He has 2 points. Lomac, front court, feeds it to CJ Scott. Mustangs looking to answer back down by double digits again. Fed out on the wing, long three on its way, off the rim, no. Colby West was looking for a foul call. It's out of bounds, headed back to National Park. Here comes Justin Davis. Top of the arc is Nikas Jackson. Guarded by two men, no problem. Turns in traffic and knocks it down for two. Another big bucket for Nikas Jackson. He has 8. Trey Tippett to Lomac for CBC. Tyshawn Pinnell right in his face. They move him down to the wing where he's trapped by White and Pinnell. Back out to Lockhart, fed in, down low. They swarm to the basketball. He stepped out of bounds. Gabe Jackson coughs up the rock for the Mustangs. NPC gets it right back. Less than 2 minutes to go here in the first half. 1:51 to play. Now it's Tyshawn Pinnell to bring his team up the floor. Guys in gray looking to finish strong here in the final moments of the first half. It's Colby West. Handoff to Justin Davis. Davis, smooth moves, trying to make a man miss. Loses the rock. Dives back on top of it. Jackson for three. Got it! What a sequence! A Nighthawk team that has no quit in them. Davis fed Jackson for a big tray. A 15-point ball game, 1:11 to play. Down low is CJ Scott. Scott over three Nighthawks. No, rebound to Kavion White. West picks up the errant pass. Nighthawks have it. 1 minute to play. White driving, looking to bring it all the way home. Count it. There's a foul. Eleven points for Nikavion White. He's looking to make it 12. The free throw is no good. Picked up by Gabe Jackson. Mustangs on the run all the way down to Lockhart. It's denied! We're going to count the bucket. It's going to be a goaltending call against Nikavion White. And Lockhart's officially on the board with two. 48.4 seconds left. The lead is 15, 45 to 30. Regardless, it was a good chase down by Nikavion White. Coach Dylan Hargrove just wanted to make absolutely sure. Are you sure about that? And it is what it is. 44 seconds left. Nighthawk rock. Nikavion White. Zone defense. Coming in for the Mustangs. And Nikavion White was left alone just a little too long. He punishes with another big dunk. The Mustangs have to shoot one more time. 25 seconds left. Tipping out on the wing. A long three on its way. Swish. Big trade coming down for Lomac. Nighthawks can hold for the final shot of the first half. Colby West with the rock. Dished out to Nikas Jackson. Spins in traffic. Says, no, I'm going to go ahead and take this shot for two. 5 seconds left. Lomac across the timeline. Pulls up. Denied by White. Ball is picked up. Tipping at the buzzer. No. At the end of the first half of action, NPC leads 49-33. It's the Ouachita Children's Youth and Family Services halftime show. We've got first half stats coming your way next. This is Nighthawk men's basketball on the Nighthawk Network.
If you or a loved one is suffering from hearing loss and looking for life-changing technologies and compassionate care, the Natural Hearing Centers is the place. They truly take the time to build a genuine relationship with you, which makes all the difference in the world.
I love the fact that John's hearing aids have helped him reconnect with family and friends, and it's improved every aspect of his life and mine.
Give Natural Hearing Centers a call today. It will change your life.
Baseball is how I rose above alcohol and drugs.
Arkansans appreciate community. We work and raise families, care for our neighbors, and come together in good times and bad. At First Security, that local strength is what we love best about our home state. There is commitment here, and heart, and hope. Thank you to everyone who is standing together, learning from one another, and making Arkansas a place we all love to call home. We're proud to be your community bank.
Success comes with many challenges. At National Park College, we've created programs that provide the tools to meet those challenges. Experience a university atmosphere at half the cost. Visit National Park College and find your path.
halftime here from the Kettle, where the Ninehawks lead 49-33. I'm Mark Oliver with National Park College. So we had a scoring discrepancy during the broadcast, if you recall, and it was a three-pointer by Tay Calloway that was ruled a two-pointer for CBC. So your score is correct on your screen as well as in the gymnasium, 49-33. First, let's see how the Mustangs got to where they are today. How about 13 points in the first half from Hakeem Hancock? Three threes and two twos for the big man. We've seen him a lot this season, and he's impressed every single game. Second on the team is Tay Calloway with 9 points for our friends from Conway. A.J. Lomack with 5 points, a two and a three, and then 2 points apiece for C.J. Scott, Dwayne Lockhart, and Gabe Jackson for the CBC Mustangs. Now for your Nighthawk men, they're led by a couple of guys after 20 minutes, Nikas Jackson and the Kavion White, each with 13 points in the first half of action. Tyshawn Pinnell with 8 points after 20 minutes, Justin Davis with 5, Quintez Grimes with 4, Jabrian Hill with 4, and 2 for Colby West. Nighthawks lead by 16 at the break. We'll take a break, and when we come back, we'll have keys to the second half for your Nighthawk men as they look for their third straight win and a big setting up a big showdown later this week in conference play. I'm Mark Oliver with Nighthawk Nation, back in a moment on the Nighthawk Network.
If you or a loved one is suffering from hearing loss and looking for life-changing technologies and compassionate care, the Natural Hearing Centers is the place. They truly take the time to build a genuine relationship with you, which makes all the difference in the world.
I love the fact that John's hearing aids have helped him reconnect with family and friends, and it's improved every aspect of his life and mine.
Give Natural Hearing Centers a call today. It will change your life.
Baseball is how I rise above alcohol and drugs.
Arkansans appreciate community. We work and raise families, care for our neighbors, and come together in good times and bad. At First Security, that local strength is what we love best about our home state. There is commitment here, and heart, and hope. Thank you to everyone who is standing together, learning from one another, and making Arkansas a place we all love to call home. We're proud to be your community bank.
Success comes with many challenges. At National Park College, we've created programs that provide the tools to meet those challenges. Experience a university atmosphere at half the cost. Visit National Park College and find your path.
Still in halftime here in the Kettle at National Park College, 49-33. The Nighthawks lead in this one. Nighthawk men, we talked about looking for win number 3 in a row, 14 on the season. They're 13-7 coming in on the year. And, of course, we've talked about the NJCAA Region 2 standings. The Nighthawks stand at 4-2 in conference play, and that's good enough for a three-way tie right now with SAU Tech and ASU Mid-South. Couple of pivotal games in Region 2 play coming up this week as the Nighthawks travel to Harrison on Thursday to take on North Arkansas College. And if you remember, that was a very high-energy environment here in the Kettle. An 80-78 victory for the Nighthawks came down to the final second. Some free throws sealed it with about a second to go. But you know, big rivalry there between the Pioneers and the Nighthawks. They go to battle in Harrison Thursday. That'll be very key in the conference standings, but maybe even more so is coming back right here to the Kettle on Saturday. 2 o'clock for the women, 4 o'clock for the Nighthawk men, as SAU Tech comes to town, the Rockets and the Nighthawks. This conference really feels wide open, but it also feels like that this game Saturday could very well determine where the conference finishes up, as February will slowly get away from us before we know it. ASU Mid-South comes to town in the Kettle on Saturday the 25th. Just 2 home games remaining for National Park College, men and women, after tonight. So if you haven't seen these teams in action yet, you're running out of time, but there is still time. Saturday, February 11, SAU Tech. That'll be a good game. Also, Saturday, February 25th against ASU Mid-South, that will also be a really good game. And, of course, Saturday the 25th will be sophomore day, so you want to make sure to make your way to the Kettle and cheer on these fantastic sophomores that have led the way for National Park College, both the men and the women this season. Prior to the game, Coach Dylan Hargrove said, you know, I'm very thankful to have CBC at a game late. There have been, you know, so many cancellations this season just in general. The Nighthawks have really kind of struggled to find games to keep everybody warm, keep everybody going, and, you know, just keep them prepared with game time reps as they look ahead to some pretty key NJCAA Region 2 games coming up. So he's very thankful for the partnership with CBC and, of course, a short trip from Conway for the Mustangs to make their way down. But his goals tonight were to try to get his starting cast as many reps as possible, but also help get those bench players some time as well. You saw Nikas Jackson coming in, scoring 13 points in the first half, tied for the team lead after 20 minutes. And Jabriant Hill getting the start tonight for Patrick Punch, who we expect to return on Thursday on the road in Harrison. And Coach Hargrove says he needs everybody on their A game for Thursday. And he's excited for a big showdown with the Pioneers on the road. In this one, the Nighthawks just look to keep their foot on the gas and really tighten things up defensively. And they think they're going to be just fine to make it to the finish line in this one. When we come back, second half of action on its way. This is Nighthawk Basketball on the Nighthawk Network.
If you or a loved one is suffering from hearing loss and looking for life-changing technologies and compassionate care, the Natural Hearing Centers is the place. They truly take the time to build a genuine relationship with you, which makes all the difference in the world.
I love the fact that John's hearing aids have helped him reconnect with family and friends, and it's improved every aspect of his life and mine.
Give Natural Hearing Centers a call today. It will change your life.
Baseball is how I rise above alcohol and drugs.
Arkansans appreciate community. We work and raise families, care for our neighbors, and come together in good times and bad. At First Security, that local strength is what we love best about our home state. There is commitment here, and heart, and hope. Thank you to everyone who is standing together, learning from one another, and making Arkansas a place we all love to call home. We're proud to be your community bank.
Start of the second half here from National Park College in Hot Springs, and NPC will have its starters back on the floor. Nikavion White, Jabrian Hill, Tyshawn Pinnell, Justin Davis, and Quintez Grimes. We are underway here in the second half of action. Hand off Quintez Grimes. Grimes looking to break the huddle. Down low, finds his jam. There it is. Grimes dunks it in for the first points of the second half. Nighthawks up big, 51-33. 6 points now for Quintez Grimes in today's contest. As CBC looks to spark a rally here. Deep three from Hancock, won't go. Loose ball controlled by Justin Davis. Coming the other way is NPC. White, front court, dishes it out, looking for Grimes, an errant pass out of bounds. Want to say hello to Nathan Davidson. It's Colby West Dad. He's watching from Houston, Texas. Thank you so much for tuning in to Nighthawk Basketball tonight. West with 2 points in the first half. As the Nighthawks come up with another steal here, White dishes it to Quintez Grimes. In the corner, Jabrian Hill thought about a three. He'll dribble around and reset up top. Tyshawn Pinnell left wide open. Why not? He takes the shot. Can't get it. Justin Davis has it taken away. It's a jump ball, and it's going to stay. No, excuse me, it'll go to CBC. Central Baptist basketball with 19:03 to play in the ballgame. Trey Tippin across the timeline. Tippin driving past a couple of Nighthawks. Dished out Hancock. The three on its way. Won't go. A heartbreaker off the rim. And Gabe Jackson will get his own rebound here. Has an opportunity from the elbow. No, misses. And it's picked up by Quintez Grimes. Cross court has Nikavion White. Thought about going up for an alley-oop. Couldn't get it. How about Jabrian Hill from downtown? It's good. Hill has his first tray of the ball game. He has 7 points tonight. The Nighthawk lead is 21. Tippin has his hands full. Out, backed off beyond the arc. He'll hand it off to Tay Calloway. Hill in his face. Calloway drives from the free throw line, fires, and he gets the bounce. Tay Calloway in the double figures now with 11 points tonight. Tyshawn Pinnell with a rock for NPC. Pinnell rounds the arc to the opposite wing. Out to Justin Davis. A three with a hand in his face, but it won't go. Rebound CBC. Mustangs coming the other way. It's Trey Tippin. Guarded by Quintez Grimes. There's the reach in foul, a little too handsy. First personal on Quintez Grimes tonight. Calloway. Or Tippin, excuse me. Inside to Gabe Jackson. Nearly fished away by Justin Davis. They'll reset up high. Tippin drives from around the elbow. Kicked out to Calloway for three. He knocks it down. Second trade of the ball game for Tay Calloway. He's the only Mustang to score in the second half. He's got five in the second half. Here's Justin Davis, a deep three, won't go. Picked up by Hancock, coming the other way of the Mustangs. 54-38, Hancock, front court, driving. Ball is tipped away. It'll stay with CBC. Trey Tippin inbound at the baseline. Fed out deep to Calloway. Jabrian Hill in his face from a free throw line. Another bank shot. It's good. Calloway heating up with 7 points here in the second half. Alley-oop jam. Quintez Grimes makes it look good. Another dunk for Grimes. 16-point ball game. Jackson swarmed by a couple of big men for NPC. Tippin pulls up for a long three. Off the rim, no. Rebound tipped by White, controlled by Jabrian Hill, and there go the boosters. Hill looking to bring it all the way home. It's short, and he draws the foul. He heads to the line, shooting two. Jabrian Hill, not sure anybody out there is faster than him, and I think maybe mom and brother back in Texas know exactly what I'm talking about. Hello to Lynette and the family. Jabrian Hill getting the start tonight, having a great showing so far. JB's at the free throw line, shooting two. First shot off the rim. Hill misses the second shot. It's picked up by the Mustangs. Callaway, front court has C.J. Scott. Scott has it dished away by Justin Davis. He hangs on to the rock. Scott, the fadeaway, won't go. Hancock with the rebound. Now he's fouled. Free throws are coming for Hakeem Hancock as each team fighting for the rock physically down low. Shout-outs to Knox getting in on the action with the cheer team tonight. First free throw is good for Hancock. It's his first trip to the free throw line tonight. He's got 14 points. Make it 15. Nighthawks want to move and move quickly. Justin Davis looking to bring it all the way home. He draws the foul, and he's all smiles as he will take a turn to the free throw line. Davis is 1 of 4 from the line tonight and looking to make good on it here in the second half. And believe there are no free throws coming. The foul will be on the floor. Fouls on Gabe Jackson, his third. The inbounds pass is stolen by Jackson. Out the errant pass looking for C.J. Scott goes over his head and awry. NPC will have it right back. Double guard set for NPC, Pinnell and Hill. We apologize for the issues with our camera. Looks like we've got it straightened out for now. Here's Quintez Grimes from the elbow for two. Grimes in double figures with 10 points. Trey Tippin with the rock for Central Baptist. Down on the wing, zone defense for the Nighthawks. On the inside, they're looking for Hancock. They've got him down low. Grimes in his face. He turns in traffic. The shot won't go. Rebound, Jabrian Hill. And there he goes, quickly into the front court. Hill looks to finish strong, and he does. Takes it all the way home for two. 9 points for Jabrian Hill. Top of the key is Gabe Jackson. They feed it on the other side. Scott's jump pass won't go. It's Nighthawk basketball. Nakavion White to bring it aboard. Played about 5 minutes here in the second half. Nighthawks in command, leading by 18. Nakavion White wide open for three. Dished out to Justin Davis, who thought about the tray. Davis drives in, nearly has it stolen away. It is stolen away. Gabe Jackson comes up with a loose rock. Jackson hears footsteps, dishes it to C.J. Scott down low, in and out. No, a heartbreaker. Hancock can't get the rebound. It's going to stay with CBC. Back into the game for the Mustangs. Number two, A.J. Lomack. I want to say hello to JC and Pete. They're watching from Waterbury, Connecticut, cheering on number two, Justin Davis, for the Nighthawks. Glad to have you. Thanks for watching. 14:35 to play. Callaway drives, backed out for a deep two. Can't get it to go. They try to fight for the tip-in. It's a foul over the back on Quintez Grimes. Second personal on Grimes tonight. Free throws coming for C.J. Scott. Scott will shoot two. First one's good. Scott misses number two. It's picked up by Quintez Grimes. The Nighthawks looking to make quick work of it into the front court here. Justin Davis, deep three, on its way, good. Davis hits his first tray of the ball game. 14:15 remaining, and the Nighthawk lead is 20. We'll have a travel call. C.J. Scott coughs up the rock for CBC. Nighthawks will have it. Nighthawk Rock, Jabrian Hill across the timeline. 14:05 remaining. Here's Tyshawn Pinnell rounding the arc. One-on-one fed to Nikavion White. Hill thought about a three. Starter step as he backs it away. Pinnell out on the wing to Justin Davis. Davis driving, spins in traffic, looking for a finish, tips it, controls it, shoots it again, and this time it's in. Justin Davis. Double figures for JD. He has 10. Now Davis is going to be charged with a personal foul, feeling the energy. Carried that momentum all the way back down to the opposite end defensively. It's Trey Tippin looking to tip in a couple of free throws here. Tippin looking for his first points of the ball game. There they are. Looking to bring it back to 20 points. Trey Tippin goes 2 for 2. Coming into the game for the first time tonight, TJ Fritz, the Kansas native, steps in for NPC as Justin Davis will take a seat. Good night for Justin Davis. 10 points with a 20-point lead for the Nighthawks as they cruise in the second half. Here's Jabrian Hill. Hill loses the rock, picked up by Callaway into the front court. Callaway sizing up the defense, fed out to Lomack in traffic. And we'll have a foul on Quintez Grimes. And if I'm correct, I believe that's going to be his fourth. It is. And that summons Nikas Jackson from the bench. It looks like Quintez Grimes has just fouled out of the game. He just got a technical foul and a double tech. And now Quintez Grimes is going to be ejected from this ball game, and that's big, with North Arc looming on Thursday. So Grimes will foul out of the ball game. And we'll see if he will be assessed that double technical. It could be extremely important with Region 2 play on Thursday. So Quintez Grimes, night is done with 10 points tonight. So into the game for NPC is Nikas Jackson. He joins Fritz, Hill, Pinnell, and White. We'll have technical foul free throws coming. Hakeem Hancock, I believe, has 4 free throws coming. Oh, 6 total free throws for Hakeem Hancock. First one, good. Second one, good. Third one, good. Four in a row. So those were the free throws for the technical fouls, and now there was an actual foul on the play, and that's where Trey Tippin's going to go to the line. Tippin's free throw, good. And we'll adjust our scoreboard to match that which is in the kettle tonight. 65-50 is what the scoreboard reads here. And they went 5 for 6, not bad. Tippin goes 1 for 2 on that opportunity. 13:05 remaining in this one. Jabrian Hill turns on the Jets, floats it up to White! The alley-oop jam! Nikavion White made that one look great. He has 15 points tonight. How does Tippin and the Mustangs respond? How about a three from Hancock? Off the mark, no. Loose ball taken by Jabrine Hill. Nighthawks have it coming the other way. Across the timeline, J.B. Hill. Hill in traffic, letting it get the push-off foul. Nikas Jackson's there for the tip-in. Yes. 15 for Jackson tonight. Behind the back, reverse layup. Hakeem Hancock for two. He has 21 points. Tyshawn Pinnell across the timeline slows things down for a moment for Nighthawk Nation. 12:08 to play. Hill sends Fritz in motion down below the baseline. There's the screen. Out to Nikavion White, 12 minutes remaining. And we've got a foul. That's a reach-in. It's going to be charged against Lomac. A.J. Lomac will have his first personal of tonight's ballgame. Nighthawks have it on the sideline. White to Hill. Tippin getting handsy with it, trying to get a steal. Out to Nikas Jackson on the wing for three. In and out, no good. Rebound on the run, Lomac. Into Hakeem Hancock, looks to lay it up and in for two. Big night for Hancock tonight. Nighthawk rock as Jabrine Hill looks to bring it coast to coast. He draws the foul. Jabrine Hill will head to the free throw line, shooting two. Hill's been to the line once tonight. He went 0 for 2, his first opportunity. .31 remaining. First shot, no good. .15 ball game. Looks like we have a substitution checking in for CBC. Gabe Jackson is back into the game for CJ Scott. Hill with another shot coming. And the Nighthawks reach 70. 10 points for Jabrine Hill. Another Nighthawk into double figures tonight. Jackson with the bounce pass on the inside, but the reach in. I believe that's going to be on Nikas Jackson. I've got three for Nikas Jackson tonight. Free throw good for Hancock. And he'll go two for two. Jabrine Hill for the Nighthawks. Dashes out to the wing. Tyshawn Pinnell steps just beyond the arc. Can't get it to go. Big rebound for Nikas Jackson. Jackson turns and fires in traffic. It's good. Another big bucket for Nikas Jackson. He has 17. Tippin in traffic. Four Nighthawks in his face. They have to back it out to Tay Calloway. Jackson fires for three from beyond the arc. Can't get it to go. Rebound, TJ Fritz. Now Fritz sprints into the front court looking for a man. Nikavion White dished out to Jabrine Hill. Wide open for three. Hill's second tray of the ball game. He has 13 points tonight. 9 of those in the second half. 10:30 to play in this one. Calloway. How about Hancock for three? That one's in. Another bucket for the leading scorer for CBC. 28 points for Hakeem Hancock. Tyshawn Pinnell out to Hill. Why not? Another three on its way. Count it. Jabrine Hill is hot from beyond the arc tonight. Halfway through the second half. Nighthawks up big, 78-59. Hakeem Hancock doing Hakeem Hancock things as he reaches 30 points tonight. Another impressive effort out of Hancock. We've seen it each time we've played CBC this season. The Kavion White boosts the Nighthawks to 80 points. 17 for White. He's tied for the team lead. Long three by Trey Tippett. In and out. No good. Tippett's going to get his own rebound. And a kickball off the foot into Kavion White. .919 to play. Fed in on the inside. How about Hancock with a floater for two? Can't get it to go. Rebound picked up and put back in. That's Drew Baxter for two. He has 4 points tonight. The Mustangs trying to storm back into this thing, down 80-63. 9 minutes to play here in the Kettle. Hill driving. Long two on its way. Off the front of the rim. No good. Rebound picked up by CBC. Lomack into the front court. Handed off to Trey Tippin. Trying to find Jackson in the middle. Tippin gets it to Gabe Jackson. Down in the wing. Drew Baxter has his hands full. And stolen away by Jabrian Hill. Hill, front court, one-on-one, looking to get it done. No, Jackson can't secure the loose ball. Hill slow to get up on the opposite end of the court. It's Hancock for three. Can't get it. Another rebound by TJ Fritz. Took a hand to the face on the rebound attempt. Out to Nikas Jackson. Jackson drives, posts up, and an errant pass as he finds Trey Tippin the other way. CBC looking to capitalize here on the turnover. On the inside, another steal for Jabrian Hill. Back and forth we go. Spin move, sets up Jackson for the dunk. It's good. 19 for Nikas. 82-63 here in the Kettle. Tippin at the baseline, steps out of bounds. Colby West back into the game for Nighthawk Nation. Tyshawn Pinnell will take a much-deserved breather. A great game so far for Pinnell. 7:45 remaining. Nighthawk rock. The Kavion White scoots into the front court. And we've got a technical foul issued against Nikas Jackson here. Something was said off the ball. We've already lost a man in Quintez Grimes. Now Jackson is in danger of being tossed. So four fouls on Nikas Jackson, and if I'm Coach Dylan Hargrove, Nikas Jackson's night's probably done regardless. I see Brody Tucker getting ready to check in. Hancock's at the free throw line again. First shot is no good. That's his first miss tonight. He's 8 of 9. Second shot is good. Into the game is Brody Tucker for the first time. So we've got Fritz, Tucker, West, White, and Hill for the home team. Up 82-64. White on the bounce pass is stolen away. Picked up by Trey Tippin. One-on-one. Tippin looking to get it done. Lays it in for two. Tippin with his first field goal of the game. He's got 5 points. It's 82-66. Front court, White hands off to TJ Fritz. Fritz off the screen, pulls up for a long three off the back of the rim. No. Rebound, Brody Tucker feeds it to Jabrian Hill. It'll stay with NPC off of a great move by Tucker to save the ball. Now Hill turns on the Jets, drives home, draws the foul. No bucket, but he's headed to the free throw line. A lot of free throws in this one tonight. Hill is 1 of 4 from the free throw line tonight. Still a lot of basketball remaining in this one. 7:05 to go. First shot good. How about 17 for Jabrian Hill? Make it 18. He's really come alive in the second half here. 14 of those in the second. 6:57 to go. Gabe Jackson has it stripped away by Tucker. Jackson's going to get it right back. Now from the corner is Lockhart for three. Off the mark, no. Rebound picked up by Baxter. And it's Hakeem Hancock who finishes with another two. 84-68. The hot-handed Jabrian Hill with the basketball for the home team. Feeds it out into Kavion White. Down low, Brody Tucker for the layup. What a dime by Kavion White. Setting up his teammate, and Tucker is on the board. Tucker known for his three-point prowess. Right place, right time for a big layup there. And how about another big layup for Hakeem Hancock? The points just keep coming. So we're going to have a whistle and a foul. The foul is against Lockhart for CBC. I've got Hakeem Hancock at 35 points with 6:12 to go. Substitution checking in is C.J. Scott. Lockhart takes a seat. Tay Calloway makes his way back into the game as well. 6:12 to go. Here's the stack. Nakavion White finds Jabrian Hill. Hill driving over to Brody Tucker. Back to T.J. Fritz. Fritz thought about a deep three there. Tucker takes a deep three. Off the rim, won't go. Rebound saved by Nakavion White. He's fouled after the play. I believe it's against Tay Calloway. And we should have free throws coming here. Four fouls on Gabe Jackson tonight for CBC. White is at the free throw line where he's 5 of 8 tonight. The first one is no good, so the 1-1, they don't get it done. And we've got a technical foul now on Gabe Jackson. So his night will be done. Jackson will foul out with 5:54 to go. It's the second player we've seen foul out tonight. One for NPC, one for CBC. And now Brody Tucker's at the line shooting free throws. First one, no good. One more coming for Nighthawk Nation's Brody Tucker. He'll knock down the second one. Three points for Brody Tucker. 5:54 remaining in this one. Trey Tippin will make his way up the floor for Central Baptist College. Finds Lomack into the front court. C.J. Scott with a jump pass finds Calloway for three. He'll knock that one down. Big shot there. And now the Mustangs looking to try to get the ball back on defense. Third tray of the game for Tay Calloway. It's 87-73. Nighthawks as Nakavion White is going to be fouled on the floor. I believe we've got a 1-1 coming. First shot for Nakavion White is no good. Gets his own rebound. They'll reset the offense here. 5:30 to go. White makes a man miss. Floater for two. Rolls on in. Nakavion White. 5:15 to play. Here's Hakeem Hancock. Hancock's going to step out of bounds on the play. And now coming the other way for National Park College. Here's the inbound to J.B. Hill, and now Nakavion White. 5:05 to go. Here's number 5, Nakavion White. It's been a big second half for Jabrian Hill for NPC. Hill drives past Tippin, puts it up in traffic. There's a foul. I believe the foul is going to be on Tippin. Question is, was it on the floor or not? I think it's going to be two shots regardless. It is double bonus. Excuse me. So Jabrian Hill is back to the free throw line. He's 3 of 6 tonight. He has 18 points tonight, 14 of those coming in the second half. And another big free throw for Jabrian Hill. The Nighthawks have 90 with 4:58 to go. Second shot good. And we've got a timeout down on the floor. Timeout CBC back in a moment here on the Nighthawk Network. 91-73, National Park College.
If you or a loved one is suffering from hearing loss and looking for life-changing technologies and compassionate care, the Natural Hearing Centers is the place. They truly take the time to build a genuine relationship with you, which makes all the difference in the world.
I love the fact that John's hearing aids have helped him reconnect with family and friends, and it's improved every aspect of his life and mine.
Give Natural Hearing Centers a call today. It will change your life.
Baseball is how I rise above alcohol and drugs.
Arkansans appreciate community. We work and raise families, care for our neighbors, and come together in good times and bad. At First Security, that local strength is what we love best about our home state. There is commitment here, and heart, and hope. Thank you to everyone who is standing together, learning from one another, and making Arkansas a place we all love to call.
91-73 National Park College as we resume play. 4:54 to play in the Kettle. Trey Tippin for CBC as it's knocked over to A.J. Lomax. Stays with the guys in black and blue. Fed across to Tay Calloway. Lomax thought about a three. A contested three. Brody Tucker got a hand in his face, and it's going to go back to the Nighthawks. How about Tucker down low looking for the reverse layup? It's good. Brody Tucker. The lead is 20. Now the pass is intercepted by T.J. Fritz, and the Nighthawks are cruising as Fritz takes it in the hole for two. Put him on the board, T.J. Fritz from Wamego, Kansas. Hakeem Hancock is going to take that one all the way for two. He's got 37 points. He's headed to the line for the and one. ...95-75 National Park College. Hancock gets it done. I've got 38 for Hakeem Hancock tonight. 4:05 to play in this one. Down low, floats it up to White. Setting up Brody Tucker, looking for a big three. He's got it. Brody Tucker from downtown. 8 points for Tucker. Now a floater from the free throw line. It's up and in. Calloway sinks the two. 98-78. Jabrian Hill takes his time across the timeline. Hill drives past two Mustangs. Can't finish. There's a foul down low. I think they're going to signal Hancock for this one. It's going to be on Trey Tippin. And that's going to send Jabrian Hill to the free throw line. The Nighthawks can reach triple digits from the line. Who else but Jabrian Hill? He's made 5 of 8 from the free throw line here in the second half. First one's good. ...21 for Jabrian Hill. ...22 points as the Nighthawks hit the century mark here in the Kettle. 3:28 to play. It's Lomack with the rock. Fed to Tay Calloway, double teamed by Tucker and Fritz. Trying to set a man in motion. Hancock pulls up for a long three with a hand in his face. He knocks it down. That'll put him past 40 points tonight. 3:04 to play. Ja'Bryan Hill crossing the timeline for NPC. Bounce pass has TJ Fritz. Na'Kavion White in traffic, guarded by Hancock, turns and fires over Hancock. It won't go. And here comes Brody Tucker out of nowhere to save the rock. Back to White for three. It's good. Na'Kavion White hits his first three of the ball game. He has 22. We've got an out-of-bounds call on Baxter. 2:32 to go. White finds Hill. Here we go. 2:30 remaining. Hand off to White, finds Colby West front and center, top of the key. West looking for a man, finds White down low. White versus Hancock, made a man miss. Now TJ Fritz from beyond the arc. It's good. Another big three for the Nighthawks. They've knocked down six trays in the second half. Fritz with 5 points. Now providing the defense, a foul over the back though. So Fritz has his first personal tonight. Free throws are coming for Trey Tippin. Tippin with 5 points tonight. Three of those coming from the free throw line. First shot, good. Tippin, second one won't go. Rebound, Na'Kavion White. There's the cross court to Fritz. He's going to lose the rock down low, take it right back, and put it back up for two. TJ Fritz flirting with double figures tonight. He's got seven right now. Down low, Baxter's shot is a little too short. Rebound, Colby West. Here come the Nighthawks. NPC making sure everybody's going to eat well tonight. 90 seconds remaining in this contest. Hill takes his time with the dribble. Opposite end finds Colby West. West, alley-oop up for Na'Kavion White. Nowhere to go. White takes it down to the wing. Pulls back for a long three. No. Falls down on the play. Picked up by CBC. Into the front court. Tay Calloway. Calloway guarded by Brody Tucker. We've got a double dribble. NPC is going to get the ball right back. For the first time tonight, we'll see Jeremiah Sanchez checking in for Central Baptist College. One minute remaining. Hand off to Colby West. Out to Brody Tucker. Step back three on its way. Can't get it to go. Loose ball picked up by CBC. Now a pull up by Hughes. Banks that one in. Devin Hughes on the board for two. Coming the other way is TJ Fritz. To Ja'Bryan Hill. Wide open for three. Count it. That's his fourth tray of the ball game. All four of them coming in the second half. 35 seconds left as the Nighthawks are going to cruise to win number 14 this season. Ball is out of bounds and the Nighthawks will have it. 30.2 seconds left. The Nighthawks will have to shoot one more time. No, they'll turn the shot clock off. Excuse me. Dylan Hargrove says, hit the brakes. And Ja'Bryan Hill will dribble out the last 20 seconds of this basketball game. NPC came in with one mission in mind, and I think they accomplished that goal tonight. They've got a big game coming up on Thursday as they travel up the road to Harrison, Arkansas for a pivotal Region 2 showdown. But they'll win number three in a row tonight here in the Kettle. 111-84, your final score. The Nighthawks get it done. Back in a moment to wrap things up here on the Nighthawk Network.
If you or a loved one is suffering from hearing loss and looking for life-changing technologies and compassionate care, the Natural Hearing Centers is the place. They truly take the time to build a genuine relationship with you, which makes all the difference in the world.
I love the fact that John's hearing aids have helped him reconnect with family and friends, and it's improved every aspect of his life and mine.
Give Natural Hearing Centers a call today. It will change your life.
Baseball is how I rose above alcohol and drugs.
Arkansans appreciate community. We work and raise families, care for our neighbors, and come together in good times and bad. At First Security, that local strength is what we love best about our home state. There is commitment here, and heart, and hope. Thank you to everyone who is standing together, learning from one another, and making Arkansas a place we all love to call home. We're proud to be your community bank.
Success comes with many challenges. At National Park College, we've created programs that provide the tools to meet those challenges. Experience a university atmosphere at half the cost. Visit National Park College and find your path.
Final score in tonight's game, 111-84. The Nighthawks get it done. Big win for National Park College. And a big night, really, for each team, respectively. First, we'll talk about Central Baptist College, where Hakeem Hancock finished with 41 points in the loss tonight, scoring nearly half of the team's total. Another impressive effort on Hancock. This is a young man going places. Absolutely. Congratulations on a huge game tonight. Tay Calloway, second on the team for CBC with 21 points in the loss. 6 for Trey Tippin, 5 for A.J. Lomack, 4 for Drew Baxter, 3 for C.J. Scott, and 2 apiece for Devin Hughes and Dwayne Lockhart. For the National Park Nighthawks, they were led by Jabriant Hill. 25 points, 21 of those coming in the second half. Second on the team was Nikavion White. Third on the team was Nikas Jackson, finishing with 19. Quintez Grimes had 10. Justin Davis had 10. 8 apiece for Tyshawn Pinnell and Brody Tucker. 7 for TJ Fritz. And rounding things out for the Nighthawks, 2 points for Colby West. Now, during the break, assistant coach Drake Henderson came to me and said, Mark, we had some history made in the Kettle tonight. And we sure did. For the first time in National Park Nighthawk program history, it's the first ever triple-double. And it went to Nikavion White tonight. 22 points, 10 rebounds, and 13 assists. And a young man that set the single-game assist record in his first game as a Nighthawk now sets the first triple-double in National Park Nighthawk history, a program that's been running since 2017 as a club team. First year of NJCAA play in 2018. Congratulations to Nikavion White on another big achievement and a historic first year for Nighthawk Nation. So the Nighthawks turn their sights to Thursday, where they travel up the road to Harrison, Arkansas, to take on a pretty good North Ark team. North Ark 3-3 in conference play. Nighthawks 4-2. That one is going to be a fun one to watch. We'll make sure we got the live stream link shared for you guys so you can join in on the fun on Thursday. Everybody's back home in the Kettle Saturday. SAU Tech comes to town. The men and the women go to battle. The women will play at 2, followed by the Nighthawk men at 4 o'clock. Once again, final score in this one, 111-84. Thank you for tuning into this edition of Nighthawk Athletics here on the Nighthawk Network. If you like what you saw tonight, like and subscribe to get notified the next time we go live. I'm Mark Oliver with National Park College. Thank you for tuning into this edition of Nighthawk Athletics. We'll see you Saturday for more Nighthawk basketball. This is Nighthawk men's basketball on the Nighthawk Network. Get 'em, Hawks.